the treaties. When Bush signed on to UNESCO,
yes, yes,
in 2004, Reagan had taken us off in 82. He put us back on it. That's why you see the statistic bureau under the census say in 2004 from the document we saw that we're now under this through UN mandate. So, you know, everything's UN orders. Sir, I report on my employees to the North American Union, and you show it to a yuppie, and they say, I don't see that. I'll hand my weapons in if the government tells me. I love government. I love being a slave. Oh, God. I can lift a finger and stop all this, but I'm not going to.
Let me ask you, did you show the 2008 revision, too, on the show? Because I certainly missed it, and I try to watch every day.
No, I saw a 2004 and a 1998.
I've got the 2008, so I'll send it over as soon as I get off the phone here, and it'll be under the title line will be Shout.
Good. Thank you so much. Listen, I appreciate your call. Title line will be Shout. We'll get that up. Better yet, write an article, because everything you said I know is accurate, so do it. I can't do it. I'm being hit from too many sides. I've been asking Paul Watson and Kurt Nimmo. Kurt wrote one last Saturday. I've been asking Paul Watson for 4 days. I said, write an article about the gun grabbing that ties it in with the White House chief of staff saying we'll all be on list, no judge, no jury, guilty until proven innocent, no owning firearms, tie it in with the bill. It hadn't happened. But they're working. Paul's writing 2-3 articles a day. Steve's writing 1 or 2 a day. Kurt's writing articles a day, updating the sites. I may have the money to hire some more webmasters and writers, but I'm scared to hire people. And by scared, I'm scared of not completing my mission. I mean, there are infiltrators, ladies and gentlemen. There are a lot of infiltrators. And, you know, it's not pretty. I mean, the feds will get in your office, and they'll come in here and commit crimes and then say, I did it. And it could come out in court that they even did it on their own, and it doesn't matter. The judge will say, it doesn't matter. We set you up. And it's, I know that's their fault and their evil, but that'll shut down what I'm doing. I mean, this isn't a game, folks. This is real. This is as hardcore as it gets. And I get all gutted up and fired up to do what I do every day, but this is real. Jason Burmes for the quick 5-minute breaking news report. Straight ahead, more of your phone calls and a lot more. I'm Alex Jones. Stay with us. Big announcements coming up.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hello, friends. This is Alex Jones. I've told you for a long time it's important to be self-sufficient, and today that's more important than ever. We need to be independent, and food and water is the key. You'll never have to stand in a bread line if you have your own bread. You'll never have to go to the Superdome and beg for FEMA to take care of your family in any emergency if you simply prepare. No one is going to take care of your family in the final equation but you. You know eFoodsDirect.com is still able to ship storable food that's safe from E. coli, salmonella, genetic alteration, or Chinese imports, and they do it at almost half the cost of last year's grocery prices. Call 1-800-409-5633 or on the web go to eFoodsDirect.com. Visit eFoodsDirect.com and look over the fine list of high-quality, freeze-dried, and dehydrated foods they have to offer. Watch the free videos, look at their online catalog, or give them a call at 1-800-409-5633. Again, 800-409-5633 or on the web at eFoodsDirect.com. Take action today. The first step is getting storable food.
In the New World Order's war against humanity, Barack Obama is the tip of the spear.
We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded.
The Obama deception completely destroys the myth that Obama is working for the best interest of the American people.
Well, Obama's already fudging. Yeah, fudged since day one in this election.
If you have a demagogue with a fanatical mass movement of personality cultists who is imposing the program of a group of extreme bankers and finance oligarchs, that's fascism.
It's not about left or right. It's about a one-world government. This film documents who Obama works for, the lies he has told, and his real agenda. Get your copy of The Obama Deception today at InfoWars.com or download it in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv. The Obama Deception. The people strike back.
Finally, in the news this evening, it's being reported that cyber spies from Russia and China have now penetrated our power grid. Even as energy experts are reporting that each summer we get closer and closer to the limits of our nation's power grid, some say that this summer's demand for electrical power may finally push the grid over its edge, creating a cascade of power outages across the country, putting us all in the dark.
Are you prepared for the next round of storm-related outages or government-created blackouts? Have you ever thought about taking steps to get off the grid and generate your own private supply of electrical power? If so, this will be the most important information you have ever heard. Solar-powered generators are finally available. They have no moving parts to wear out or break and require absolutely no gas whatsoever. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun. So go to mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Check out mysolarbackup.com before you lose your power.
And we're gonna ride.
And we're gonna ride.
We're gonna ride on a ride. Ride like the one-eyed.
Ride like a one-eyed Jack of Diamonds.
With the devil close behind.
We're gonna ride.
All right, more of your calls coming up from Thomas, Steve, Charles, Tony, and John. That'll probably be all we can get to. Jason Burmes, will you hand me that fly swatter, please?
Got it.
You know, we have hundreds of emails pouring in telling us how to get rid of fruit flies. No one knows where they're coming from, and they're just everywhere, and they're landing on my face. And we got fly paper, and they don't like the fly paper. They don't care about the fly paper. They're like, well, spray a bunch of poison. I don't want to breathe a bunch of poison. I'm not using it in here. You can keep your cancer for yourselves out there. You know, I was over at my parents' one weekend standing there, and I came in the house about midnight. A couple of roaches running around, big ones, you know, got around here. It's been raining a lot. They come in the house. I killed them with a kitchen rag, popping them. I could have gone and got poison out from under the counter, but no, I don't feel like killing them and killing myself to live. Okay, now I'm going into ancient exterminating tactics. That's how they used to kill locusts, was like these big switches. Then in the field. Hand killing the insects. Okay, let's get serious. Let me reset here just a moment because I want to get to this with Burmes and then get to your calls. It has come out with top virologists in England, the United States, Canada, Australia. We got two articles, one up at Infowars.com, one at PrisonPlanet.com. Just recapping this and then the new breaking news in a moment. It has come out. That Tamiflu developer says swine flu may have been released from a lab. And then there's another article dealing with that. And so the point is H1N1 virus manufactured or result of human error. They're saying clearly it has the markers. It has no pedigree. It wasn't mutated naturally because they can track these viruses. It just came out of the blue, wrong flu season, wrong hemisphere, which is also why I say it didn't escape from some lab. This thing had to be spread. So this is only a whitewash one level, but we're proven right again. Will we see retractions from CNN and others that attacked us? No. But now we know why they're mainly taking down the swine flu videos I did that are on YouTube, suspending the accounts of the videos everywhere. It's me. I'm allowed to get on TV and talk. I'm telling people they can post it, but YouTube says no. They don't even do copyright infringements now. They just take your channel down. Happened to Nate Evans, happened to all the people I know. This is a badge of honor, I think. And Burmes, you kept saying they were going to get rid of Google Videos. We'll talk about that in a moment. But right now, briefly, I remember this in the extras of Oliver Stone's JFK because a new director's edition came out a few years ago, and I watched it, you know, on the treadmill. That's how I watch movies, is, you know, in like a two-part series, you know, an hour on the treadmill and then another hour on the treadmill the next day. And I remember them talking about how Castro, how a type of flu, a type of fever, swine fever had been released in Cuba. And then it came out years later in the mainstream news, and that's declassified. I'd forgotten. You got an email, got a tip, pulled up the San Francisco Chronicle article. It's confirmed. So 76, it pops up on a military base. 1918, it comes out of a U.S. military base. This new one created in the lab. No doubt about that now. And who's used this stuff before? The CIA and against Latin America. These guys.